F5 Labs, in collaboration with Effluxio, researches global attack traffic to gain a better understanding of the cyber threat landscape. Cyber attacks take many forms, but they often start with the hunt for exploitable services. We analyze scans of global low-interaction honeypot traps across three quarters of 2021, specifically comparing activity from the first two quarters, January through June, against the third quarter, July through September. So let's start the clock for how global cyber threats changed over 2021. Since the internet began, threat actors have scanned a wide range of IP ports to find potential targets. Each port represents services that can be probed for vulnerabilities and exploited. All the way up until 2021, the top three scan ports have been the same: VNC 5900, SSH 22, and RDP 3389. All are used for remote logins, giving direct internal access, and all three slightly declined in Q3 of that year, with corresponding increases in the scanning of MySQL 3306, FTP 21, and Elasticsearch API 9200. Now, let's turn our attention to who is doing the scanning. Lithuania was the country of origin for most scans in 2021. Why? The answer comes from Lithuania's State Security Department, which stated in March 2021 that Russian cyber attackers had misused its country's IT infrastructure to attack other organizations developing COVID-19 vaccines. In fact, as the Lithuania source traffic waned, probably as it cleaned up the infections, the Russia source traffic rose again. Some recommended practices to mitigate these types of attacks include prioritizing hardening and patching for exposed ports that are commonly attacked, enabling multi-factor authentication on every remote login service you can, implement a robust password policy on whatever you can't, and use an anti-bot solution to reduce brute force and credential stuffing attacks on logins. To get deep insights on how global cyber threats changed over 2021, visit f5labs.com. I'm Peter. Thanks for watching, liking, subscribing, and checking out our other videos. And I'll see you next time on 90 Seconds of Security.